So there's been something I've really wanted to do for the last couple weeks, and I've just been waiting for the weather to get right. So I've seen a number of YouTubers who have gone out after it's rained, and they've tried puddle photography. They get the reflection of a landscape, or a person, or an object inside a puddle, and they get that perfect reflection lining it up right. And I've seen that, I'm like, that's super cool. So today, it finally has rained, there's still water on the ground, we're gonna go downtown, kinda more towards the evening, nighttime, and we're gonna go try to get some sweet photos and see how it goes. So yeah, let's get right to it. Came down here to do some splash photography, and I dropped my water bottle and it broke. So I started losing water fast, and I tried to get a good photo and it didn't work. So we're gonna try to get some other photos though of the downtown area. There's still some really cool lighting going on, and I think we can get some cool stuff, but it looks like we're gonna have to change some plans there. So we'll do that instead. Not go as planned, but that's okay. That's kind of what photography is all about, you know? You just kind of go with what you get. You can't always plan out the perfect shoot. You can't always get the perfect results, but that's okay. That's part of art, is adapting, learning to adapt, and that's what we did. So in this situation, when we got there, the first thing I realized was there was no puddles after the rain. He was like, where did they go? And I thought there'd be puddles, and they were all gone. There's almost zero puddles. And then I had brought a water bottle to pour and make more puddles. And what ended up happening was I dropped the water bottle, fell out of my backpack, and it broke, and the water spilled out, and I had to throw it away. Total fail. Literally, nothing was exactly how I wanted. I didn't get really the splash photos I had thought I would get. But it's art. You learn to adapt. You learn to try new things. So what I ended up doing was just walking around, taking photos of the neon lights, getting just fun video of the downtown area. There's a super cool street, and you'll see where there's the lights hanging up on top, and then obviously all the restaurants and places on the side. And that is one of the coolest places, I think, in St. Cloud, like that street with just all these like lights hanging up on top. Super neat and interesting. It was fun because I walked around and I got these different, you know, unique photos that I wouldn't have gotten if I had the water there. But then on the way back, I still was able to actually find this puddle that was like really nice and big, and I was able to take that puddle and get a really cool photo here. Check this out. And I was able to get this photo by getting super low, and it was a nice perfect reflection of the building scape above and then below. It's super awesome. Also, sometimes you get creative, right? So I was walking around, there were no puddles. I was like, well, where can I find a reflection? Where can I do this? And I actually ended up going and I found this trash bin, okay? There's a trash bin, and on the lid, there was some water, like a little puddle. And so I was able to frame it up perfectly. And I got a photo of the Mexican restaurant, Mexican Village, with the reflection on the trash can. You know, you would know from the picture, but you get this reflection on this trash can from the water there. And that worked perfect. You don't need water on the street. You can have water on the trash can, water anywhere, anywhere that's reflective. And so, as a photographer, instead of just expecting that what you want is going to be there, being a good photographer is about adapting, learning to see what you've got, and learning to make that look good, right? And being able to take really sweet photos and awesome photos while changing environments, you know, situations you can't control, right? I can't control the fact that the plane stopped too soon and there was no puddles left, okay? But I can control my creativity. I can control how I find and look for photos and what I do about that situation. So that's all. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're not already. And I will see you later. We've got some fun stuff coming up.